Well, you wanted Goku, and now here's Goku. I thought I was really slow, which I am. Wow, that's awful. To be clear here, no one actually did comment and ask for Goku. I was merely just making a joke about how... I don't know. Every time a new Smash game comes out, or at least since Brawl, really. Well, we didn't really... I wasn't really on the internet a whole lot when Melee and the original were about to come out, but every time a new Smash comes out, everyone always jokingly says, "Where's Goku?" That joke actually... A couple of times I actually heard that joke for "Where's Cloud?" And then Cloud actually got put in. Then we all got to collectively say... Remember all those times that Cloud was in a game on a Nintendo 64 console? Good times. Still trying to figure out this moveset. Well,
share your energy with me.
So am I gonna charge for like 2 more minutes? Okay, or maybe that. Ooh, I like that. That's like a diagonal Falcon kick. Actually, that is pretty much exactly like a Falcon kick, except it's a side B and not a regular B or down B. I know what I'm talking about. Sometimes. Okay, maybe not all the times. Yes, maybe, not really, no. No idea what this down B is. Up B isn't really doing me much good when I don't really need to gain word momentum. We don't want to lose the first round.
I'd like to fight you again sometime.
So... correct me if I'm wrong, in the DBZ franchise, is fighting almost like a euphemism? Like, you could replace fight with, you know, the other thing, and it might work exactly right in each instance. I might just be crazy. No idea what this down B is doing. I don't even know how I am doing that. Oh, so this happens when I use the side B on the ground, and this happens when I use it in the air. That's neat. Well, that sucks. Interesting reskin of Yoshi's story? I think that's what the Smash 64 stage was. Also, am I really... weird amalgamation of various parts. Also, Gex is here, and that's hilarious, because Gex is hilarious. Not because his jokes are actually funny, but just as a reminder that the 90s were a very silly period in time. A very entertaining period of time, or at least it was for me since I was a kid, but you get what I mean. Also, this is totally not a Young Link skin. Are you kidding me? Zelda 2 was Adult Link, because, you know, he does that thing where he goes into the house with the... And I'm gonna stop right there. So is this actually Young Link then? Okay, yeah, it is Young Link, because I know it's Young Link because it has fire arrows. That was the main distinction in Melee, which also reminds me, do we have milk? I have no idea what the heck I'm doing. I think I should stop looking at that. Should have seen that coming. And really? Let me move! Or not. I didn't want to move in that way. Now, I gotta say, the graphics on this particular stage are way better than what you actually see in the Yoshi Story games, which... I didn't know until I watched someone Let's Play it a couple of years ago that game is actually entirely sprite-based, which is pretty unusual for a Nintendo 64 game since, you know, 3D stuff and polygons were the new hotness, so we put it in everything whether you wanted to or not. I want presents from the party ball. Boy, that's a weird skin. So whenever you try to make things 3D, it's weird. Or 2D. That's what I meant. Which I think I read somewhere that Mr. Game & Watch is not actually 2D in this game. He's just a polygon that's only visible from... Like, he has a bunch of invisible sides. I shouldn't be talking about this during the fight, because I barely know what it is I'm talking about. Looks like I got a elemental effect on my up B too, which I don't remember from Melee. But it's also been quite a while since I've played that, and how exactly did I do that? That was kind of weird. I have no idea how I won that. Oh my goodness gracious. Well, this ought to be interesting. I like how Shadow has a sword with this particular skin. Use it? No. That'd be pretty funny if he did, though. Man, I have barely played Sonic and the Black Knight, but I kind of consider it as part of what I like to call the unholy trinity of Sonic games. Basically, in my opinion, the three worst Sonic games, which were all released within a couple of years of each other. Those happen to be Sonic and the Black Knight, Sonic 2006, and Shadow the Hedgehog, which is probably the better of those three games. I did play a little bit of Black Knight back in the day, around a little bit after it came out. There was a library near the college I went to, and they just happened to have a couple of random Wii and PS2 games in their library, and one of them was Sonic and the Black Knight, so I rounded up my friend who is a big Sonic fan and did not want to be subjected to it, but I kind of convinced him to go ahead and play it with me anyways. Best part of the game by far is when you go to the in-game shop and Tails is just there, and it's just a picture of Tails as a blacksmith, and the only thing you hear is just Tails going, "Welcome." That's like the voice of reason within the worst Sonic games. So I suppose if I were making a unholy trinity of Sonic games now, I'd probably swap... Jeez, what was the name of the most recent one again? Boom, I'd swap Sonic for Shadow the Hedgehog, because it's bad, but it's not as bad as those other ones. Which, while we're on the subject of Sonic games and Shadow in particular, my favorite ending in Shadow the Hedgehog is one who take the bad route almost the entire way through, and then take the good route as the very last decision right before the ending. And so Shadow's basically about to kill Robotnik or something, I think. It's been a while since I've played. But instead, Shadow just goes, "I am the ultimate hedgehog!" Yeah, that's a lesson that he learns. The ultimate hedgehog. The ultimate death of hedgehogs. Mr. Game & Watch! I am the ultimate hedgehog! This is who I am. Yes! Not the right type. Also, hold on a second, is that CDI Link? That sure as heck looks like CDI Link. I can't wait to bomb some Rayquazas. And I went into this fight not intending to make a whole... Whoops. I will admit, I was kind of thinking along the lines of Smash 4 and totally forgot about what the down B in this game did. But that's fine. This is fine with me. In fact, okay, you can't do that in midair. Forgive me, I haven't done this in forever. It was really cool having three characters in one with the whole... What the heck? Those bombs are way more powerful than they should be. Back on my previous train of thought that got stuck in the station for a while. The whole Pokemon trainer thing, but it kind of made sense that if they were going to only keep one character, it was going to be Charizard. Maybe if they had done it in a different way, in which a different one of the original trio was the evolved form, they'd pick that. But I'm pretty sure Charizard is more popular than Venusaur or Bulbasaur. I mean, or Blastoise. I could be wrong about that. But yeah, let's... No! That time I totally intended to do the Rock Smash thing, and forgot that it's a side B and not down B. There we go. That's good for some good old healthy damage. Yeah, there's a couple of moves that are different in here, but I think I've got this under control. Link. As it is written, you have died. You failed to win, I guess. Nice, Smash Brothers Infinite to invite us over for a bunch of random new stages and hacks. Gay Luigi, I hope they made lots of custom music that somehow matches in with the stages. Luigi, look! It's from Nintendo. Dear pesky plumbers, the lawyers and I have taken over the custom games. The Brawl Hacks are now a permanent guest of nowhere because we tried to take them away. I dare you to play them anyway if you can. We gotta play the Brawl Hacks, and gotta help us. If you need instructions on how to play the Brawl Hacks, follow the hack that I put in the description of the first one of these videos. I am not gonna lie, I kinda wanted to attempt to do an entire recreation of Hotel Mario using this stage, and then I realized it's just a background of the beginning of the first part of the game, so that wasn't really gonna work. But there was a time period in college when me and my friend, different friend from the Sonic and the Black Knight story, where we would just describe our entire lives based around changing up the intro for Mario. It's being like, invite us over for an exam, or invite us over for a party, or you get the point, invite us over for a basketball game. I dare you to find the basketball players if you can. I gotta stop getting these 2D models, although this one is significantly less nightmare fuel-y than the one from, I think from a while ago. You've fallen right into my trap. This doesn't count, right? He's not getting damaged for this, I don't think. Can I just win? That'd be nice. No, I don't want that. I don't want that. Be a dump and not use your final smash? Oh. Nope. He cut out the music. What monster! If you could not take advantage of my drunken stupor, that'd be nice. Me forgetting my moves and dying anyway. Maybe I deserve that for that bad rendition of the Hotel Mario intro. I'm just Luigi. Stand still here and hope no one notices me. Where do all these Sonic characters keep coming from? Also, I'm flying around a little weird-ish. Really floaty. Also, I know this music isn't... Okay, I guess that's what my... I have no idea what any of these moves are doing. I know that this music isn't from Pirates of the Caribbean, but it totally sounds like it is. Maybe that's just me, and maybe that's just because... Oh wait, this is not the original game! I should know exactly what this is. This is the Shadow Moses Island Smash Brothers edition or whatever. That's what the soundtrack called it, anyways. But now, maybe that's just me, because what? Oh my gosh. I totally thought that you were Young Link because of the skin. No, please don't kill me. Apparently I died in that and I didn't even get to watch myself float around for a whole bunch. Anywho, I play a lot of Age of Empires 2, and there's a lot of just random sound track mods out there on the Steam Workshop. And the one I used the most recently was one that changed the soundtrack to this stuff from Pirates of the Caribbean, so I've been listening. That's a roundabout way of me saying I've been listening to that particular soundtrack recently. I like how I'm able to create... no? Batons? Or bones? Oh yeah. That would make sense since I'm sans serif. I know he's from Undertale, but I've played approximately, oh, maybe 25 minutes of Undertale combined? Something like that. Xbox Brett, you can see where it is, right? Ever since the 360, and even with the one, they've kept the circular X logo type thing, and that's totally what it looks like. Is this a counter? Also, I did not realize that Skullkid had the Dark Fairy ability. I think I've only played as him like once. Please ignore me as I continue to still have no idea what I'm doing. For those of you wondering, I actually do like Sonic Unleashed. So much so that it was the first game I really played when I bought my 360. And after I completed the game, I made a Facebook page for Chip Like Gaia. But please don't go there, because I just kind of leave it there and ignore it. What the heck? What's up with Skull Kid in a Jar?
Brother in a Jar!
Let's just run through all the Sonic characters, why don't we? I actually did not mind the Big the Cat stages in Sonic Adventure 1, but that was mostly because I was coming into it after having already played Sega Bass Fishing, which is a pretty amazing game, if not mostly for the fact that as soon as you get up by this big rainbow word art giant thing that just says FISH shows up, and then the super crazy rock and roll music starts playing. Is it just me, or is the music like really, really loud on this stage? It at least for me, as I'm playing, it sounds way louder than normal. So if I'll try and see what I can do in editing, but just hopefully it'll be an issue that only pursues for this one particular fight. Why don't I do myself a very silent big gay dance? Wow, nearly everyone died during that. Come on, Zelda, nearly everyone. I seriously just get hit by one of my own Goros or Grumbos or whatever the heck they call those spiky things. Also, do I have like a... Oh, I have a fish on my hook. That's why I'm able to use this hammer. That's kind of clever, actually. Really glad I didn't actually accidentally go in the water there. It's taking a while for me to remember that swimming is a thing in this game. But that also means that drowning is, although I will say this. In all my years of playing Smash Bros., my original game save file has still only ever had one person drown on it, according to the stats page. And that's mostly just because I did it on purpose so that I could, you know, for completion's sake, say I've done one of everything. Alright, come on guys, hurry it up. We gotta get to the next one. As if there already weren't enough pretty boy anime sword fighters in this game. And by that I of course mean more Sonic characters. And more movesets, I have no idea what's going on. Also, we appear to be missing sound effects here. I don't really know what's going on, but hey look, we've got a nice little platform over here to hang out on for no reason. Maybe that's not a good idea, because I have no idea if Kid Buu, I hope I'm saying that right, has projectile-based attacks or not. Also, I thought I was supposed to be using a sword, but I mean, with the skin, it's probably in sword, but I was still expecting to be using a sword. I like the rain effects. It's a nice touch. Ooh, what is that? It's really silent, so it's scary. This is a very silly fight. Man, I thought I had shielded at the right time. Also, is that the CPU taunting me? You know, we've had a lot of problems with custom boards in Mario Party with AI characters not knowing how to play it, but we haven't really experienced AI fighters in Smash Brothers not knowing how to handle those movesets. Or maybe we have, and I just haven't been paying that much attention. Okay then. Cool beans.
The winner is...
Okay, last random Sonic character, I promise. Just had to get a nice look at that, since I have no idea what the... Oh my gosh, I like that. I was just tapping the A button. Oh man, a lot of these... anime characters, or maybe I'm just drawing the wrong comparisons here, but they seem to have really fast dashes and really, really slow walks. Not like you'd normally be walking a whole lot in this game anyway, but it's just an observation that I made today. Also, that's another counter. Add that to the list. What are we at, like 17,000? I know I'm not, it's probably not meant to be this way, but oh my god. At this particular stage, I almost kind of feel like playing it like, Little Mac, you know, just trying to stay on the ground. I really like that. You know, I always thought Sonic should, try and hit people with his spikes more. I guess that's the whole point of rolling up into a ball, but the majority of games, it's mostly... you just see the ball, and it looks very round and smooth, unlike a somewhat furry stone, I suppose. Oh wait, Mario hadn't died yet? I mean, Paper Mario hadn't died yet? I had to pause at the start, because I wanted to know if that was like a skin, and it took, and I didn't like actually glance down at the bottom to see that it was actually Paper Mario, not Paper Mario. Oh, hey, wait a minute, this is like, Captain Falcon's down smash, that's good to know. More things, in general, need to be more like Captain Falcon. More people should be given the opportunity to Falcon Punch things. That's what I say, anyways. Have I shown off all my moves? Okay, good. Can't finish this fight without having done that. I guess I haven't really done a whole lot of aerials, but... I don't even know who Broly is. Yeah, I did say that right. I know someone named Brody, but I don't think that's who it is. I mean, it's possible, I suppose. Smash Ball? I'd like to use the Smash Ball. I don't like that pile driver thing. Okay, cool, that does damage. That's good to know. Actually, we don't know what Paper Mario's final smash is either, so, transformation, I'm assuming? Well, I would say that made my attack very much powerful. I can say words. But he was already at a pretty high damage, so I don't know. Does Paper Mario have a black M? Maybe I should check that later. This map is just called Dave's House. It's probably from Earthbound, but I just like to imagine it's just some random guy named Dave that the developer knows. This is probably an Excite Biker. I didn't have any idea who it was, but yeah, I was saying earlier that more people need to have the opportunity to Falcon Punch things, and I needed to do that before we wrapped things up today. From the character selection screen, I kind of thought with the white helmet, which it took me a while, admittedly, to figure out that it was a white helmet. I saw it, and I thought, oh, maybe it's some random Halo character I'm not aware of. I mean, the last one I played was 4, so... which I guess really only leaves, what, one game? Like, one main series game that's come out since then? Man, I keep getting rid of the Dragoon because it seems to have much too big of an effect on these two stock games. But then the game will randomly crash and I'll forget about it. There's a couple of stages I attempted to load during today's recording session, where it would just throw an error on my screen and the game would continue fine. I just ignored it and hit OK. However, it would just keep coming up regardless. So I could hold down the enter button and the game would like go almost normal, but not quite. But how am I supposed to play like that? Falco Punch! Sometimes I feel like the game hasn't started unless I've Falcon Punched one. Similar attitude that I have towards Soul Calibur. Yeah, that's the name of that game. Except instead of Falcon Punches, it's grabs. Something I don't really use in this game, but use a ton in Soul Calibur. Darn you, lip of building! Alright, one more round for me today, and I'll do it as I have the past two times and just go full random and subject myself to the RNG. Oh, Final Destination. That's... Oh my goodness! What is happening here? I can't even pay attention to what character I am because this is really goofy. Admittedly, I have played this stage before on someone else's brawl hack they made. I don't remember what they called it, but it was just a stage called Final Frustration. And it's kind of hilarious because it just tilts back and forth. Wow, my blue thingamajigger goes through the stage. That was admittedly very cheap. Does this thing go all the way around and upside down at some point? It'd be pretty hilarious if it did. I have played as this character today. I just kind of forgot, and I guess I never used the down B, because the down B's a little OP. Oh boy! Is it based off of, like, the way we jump on it, or is it just random? I'm gonna say it's random. Wow! I don't know if I could have scripted it better than myself. Congratulations! Well, that was fun. See you guys later.